Good morning, Ben. How's things, man? It's been a while. Here is my new place. I'm not sure, you can't see it very well, and I don't want to move the camera because my laptop has decided to be cranky today, so it keeps crashing the videos. But this wall behind me here is not the wall that you saw previously, or the wall that you saw previously to that, because that was in Wellington. So, to business. There's lots of stuff that's happened in my life in the past, however long, since we chatted last. But I don't think we're going to have time to go through all of it, so I'm just going to talk about an idea, or three ideas which kind of link up together, and then when we Skype next, we'll be able to talk about normal life stuff. The idea stems from the work that I've been doing in my social critical theory course, and specifically with regards to Jürgen Habermas and his theory of communicative action. So I should probably first describe what social critical theory is. So social critical theory is a multifaceted, cross-disciplinary research field in philosophy, sociology, anthropology, psychology, lots of different ologies, which attempts to describe, prescribe, and critique normative claims about the function of society. Unlike earlier philosophers, such as Rousseau, Hobbes, Marx, or Hegel, and closer to the time that Habermas was working, Max Horkheimer and Theodore Adorno, Habermas attempts to ground his social critical theory in everyday language. This theory starts with the premise that each of our interactions with the world fall into four distinct categories: the objective world, the normative world, the subjective world, and the life world. In interacting communicatively, participants attempt to achieve consensus through forwarding relativized and criticizable validity claims. These are claims that are open to objective appraisal, based either on truthfulness, rightness, or sincerity, which thematize one or more elements of the objective, social, and subjective worlds. Each of these claims correspond to a different structural component of the fourth world, the life world, with truth-based claims accessing cultural elements, rightness-based claims accessing normative elements of society, and sincere communicative utterances accessing the personalization of individuals within the life world. In raising these claims, actors simultaneously reproduce and maintain
the life world.
And Habermas uses this description as the foundation for his normative account. Okay, so that was a little bit dry, so you got to the end of it, here's a puppy. The main thing that this theory of communicative action got me thinking about was the way that different people view the world, especially the different world filters that they place onto their understanding of their natural environment. For example, when I was walking down the street today, I was struck with almost a paroxysm of the vast complexity and multiplicity and diversity and sheer size of the world. Just the resolution of life itself. Every person has a different background, is a different objective world in which they judge facts and they judge the truthfulness or falsity of those facts. Equally, everyone has a different view of what the normative world looks like, what the social world looks like. What is the correct way of eating dinner? What is the accepted formality level? Should I wear a tie? Should I not wear a tie to this event? And furthermore, and most importantly, everyone has their own deeply, definitionally subjective, extremely personal world that they house within themselves, their emotions and their feelings. Picturing and trying to empathize with all of the different ways that other people are thinking about the world as I walk down the street, terrifying. When you see the complexity at which you describe the world to yourself, and then you extrapolate out that complexity to every single individual on the planet, and you realize that they're both different and different in ways that you can't even imagine. I'm still grappling with it now. And this need to be able to control and to be able to visualize the way that the world is and the way the world functions, both yourself and the way that the world functions for others, is an inherent trait that the first generation Frankfurt theorists think is grounded in fear and will lead inevitably to totalitarianism and Stalinism. I'm not quite there yet, don't worry, I'm not a young Stalin, But it's something that's really been brought to the fore in the last kind of 2 weeks, and I've been thinking about it a lot. Okay, so this video is already getting quite long, but the very basic idea of how the artist, Robert Ellis, ties into this picture is that Habermas argues that the media subsystems basically just means ways that we interact of money and power do not act in a communicative way. So when we exchange power and when we exchange money, we don't do so in order to orientate ourselves towards mutual understanding. All we're doing is we're acting strategically. In acting this way, we lose access to the life world itself. We lose access to the assumptions and the preconditions upon which our life is based. And because of this, crucially because of this, we don't have the ability to adequately critique the pathologies of society. Ellis's work attempts to re-engage this life world with the general public, bringing images of cityscapes and landscapes that are disparate, somewhat enigmatic, but still deeply personal and relatable to the everyday viewer. I personally think the works are crazy cool and captivating, and just you can just fall into them, and they mirror very much the types of ideas of increasing complexity, social and environmental ramifications of that, mirroring the psychological ramifications of that that I've been thinking of in regards to both the life world and communicative action. I think that his work also is a perfect reminder of the way that art can be used as a form of communication and a form of symbolic representation that can't be enumerated in words alone. And I just think they're really cool. So that's my thought for the day. There'll be a link in the doobly-doo of the essay that I wrote in regards to Habermas, the theory of communicative action, and more specifically the colonization of the life world in respect to New Zealand society. And I'll also put a link down to some of Robert Ellis's work if you want to go check it out yourself. I hope you're doing well back in America and everything's going smoothly. I hope your friend is A-okay and he's reinstated back into university life. Can't wait to hear from you soon. Even out.